Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today I'll show you how to create this dynamic text animation inspired by one of my voices. First, let's create a new composition. We'll name it Render. Under Presets, choose Social Media Square 30fps and set the duration to 20 seconds. And you can leave the background color black and then press OK. Now let's add a text layer. I'm using the pitch font set to black from Adobe Fonts. Set the text size to 386 and the color to white. For this tutorial, I'll use the word hero, all capitals. Feel free to follow along with the same word to make it easier for yourself. Next, let's center the text using the align tool, which you can see up here. If you can't see the align tool, simply go to Windows and click on Align. And now you'll have to turn off the cap locks in order to be able to see your text. Next, we'll need to center the anchor point using the pan behind tool. To do this, select the text layer, click on the pan behind tool, which can be found up here, and Command or Ctrl click the anchor point and move it to the center of your composition, like shown. Then, with our text layer selected, press S on your keyboard to bring up the scale properties. Unlink the scale properties by pressing here to animate the Y value without changing the X value. Then, set a keyframe at the first frame by pressing the stopwatch. Then scale in a wee bit, so scale in a small bit, so that you can see 1 second, excellent, and move the playhead along to 1 second, and at 1 second, increase the Y value to 115%. Then move the playhead along to 2 seconds, and set it back to 100%. Then move the playhead along to 4 seconds and increase the Y value to 130%. Then move the playhead along to 6 seconds and decrease the Y value back to 100. And then move the playhead along to 8 seconds and increase the Y value to 130. And finally, move the playhead along to 10 seconds and decrease the Y value back to 100. Excellent. That's all our scale position set. Next, with the text layer selected, go to Effects and Presets. If you can't see Effects and Presets, go to Window and then turn on Effects and Presets. Now in Effects and Presets, search for Warp and double click to apply to the text layer. And under the Warp Effects controls, set the bend amount to 0. And then let's animate the warp effect. Now using the next keyframe arrows, move your playhead along to 2 seconds. And at 2 seconds, add a keyframe for horizontal distortion. Then move the playhead along to 4 seconds, and at 4 seconds, set the horizontal distortion to -100. Then move the playhead along to 6 seconds, and at 6 seconds, bring it back to 0. Then move the playhead along to 8 seconds, and at 8 seconds, increase it to 100. Then move the playhead along to 10 seconds, and at 10 seconds, decrease it back to 0. Following on, to add more movement, let's apply the CC Bender effect. So go to Effects and Presets, and search for CC Bender. Make sure your text layer is selected, and double click to apply CC Bender to your text layer. To begin with, change the style from bend to Marlin. And we're going to animate the bender effect just like we animated the warp effect. So move your playhead to 2 seconds. So to 2 seconds, and at 2 seconds, add a keyframe for the bender amount. Then move your playhead to 4 seconds. And at 4 seconds, set the bender amount to 7.8. Then move the playhead along to 6 seconds and set the bender amount back to 0. Then move the playhead along to 8 seconds and set the bender amount to -7.8. Then move the playhead along to 10 seconds and set the bender amount back to 0. Excellent, now that's all the effects and keyframes we'll be using for this animation. To make the animation smoother, we'll use the Easy Ease function now. So, with the text layer selected, press U to bring up all the keyframes and highlight all of them. You may need to zoom out now to make this easier. So highlight all the keyframes and press F9 to Easy Ease them. Of course, you can go into the graph editor and fine-tune the keyframe movements further, but for simplicity of this tutorial, we'll stick with Easy Ease. Now, let's pre-compose the text layer so we can loop it. Right-click on it and select Precompose and call it Text Comp and press OK. Next, we'll trim the text composition. Double-click on the Text Comp to open the text composition, and now with the text layer selected, press U to bring up the keyframes and adjust the work area to 10 seconds to your last keyframe. You may need to zoom in for greater accuracy. So we'll adjust it to 10 seconds, exactly where your last keyframe is. Now up here, right click and press Trim Comp to Work Area. Now go back into the render comp. So go back into the render comp here and right click on the text layer and go to Time, Enable Time Remapping. And Alt-click on the stopwatch. So Alt-click on the stopwatch and add the expression loop out. If you zoom in, you may notice a black frame at the last keyframe. To fix this, add a keyframe 1 frame before the final keyframe. So just 1 frame before, add a keyframe, and then delete the last keyframe. Excellent. And now if you play this back, it will loop seamlessly. Now, here's some final touches if you want to make it match what you saw on the intro. Open the text comp and double click on the text layer to highlight the text. And now go over to stroke and turn it on and set the stroke amount to 4. Lastly, go back to render and add a background. So right click, select new and solid. Set the color to FFDE59. So as you can see here, FFDE59 and press OK and then OK again. Now you'll just need to move the solid layer below your text comp like shown. And that's it. You've created a dynamic text animation inspired by Matt Voyce. If you found this tutorial helpful, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe for more tutorials like this. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.